Hey, it's Pete. Welcome back to my workshop. This is going to be the first in a series of videos following the process of restoring my DM2800 milling machine. Now, this machine needs quite a bit of work. It needs some mechanical work. I'm going to be completely retrofitting the electronic package, and there's a few parts that are just plain missing. Now, even with all that work ahead of me, I still think it's worthwhile because it is a well-built machine, and I got it for next to nothing. Now, this has been a long-term project. I've had this machine for about 6 years now. I don't really know anything about the history of it because I got it at an auction. And during the course of that time, I've started and stopped numerous times, and it's time just to power through and get this thing done. Now, I've got another small mill here in the shop, and I do a lot of CNC milling of aluminum on it. But unfortunately, that machine, it has very small capacity, and the spindle only goes up to about 3K, where this DM2800 has the 10K spindle option, so that's going to be a really nice upgrade for me, in addition to the larger bed size. Now, like I said, I don't know anything about the history of the machine. It almost looked like maybe it was adjacent to a fire at one point in its life, because there was a lot of heavy surface rust on the bed of the machine some of the ways, and it was covered in a black soot that didn't really look like a byproduct of machining. So when I got this machine home from the auction, I powered it up and checked it out. Two of the three axes worked and the spindle worked, and then after that dug into it and started tearing the thing apart. Now, I have very little video footage of that process. I do have quite a few pictures, though, and I'll be sprinkling them in where they're appropriate. So to get you up to date, basically, we tore the thing apart, cleaned it, painted some things. A few pieces decided to paint green for no particular reason, and that's really where we're at. So that's where we are at this point. The machine's been pretty well cleaned. Little items have been fixed here and there as I've gone along. One item that was noted was that the belts that attach the stepper motors to the ball screws, they had several teeth just stripped off of them. So I began the process of searching the web to find new belts for it, and actually did find a source for belts, but of course they had a minimum order. So if anybody needs belts for their DM2800, give me a call. I have a few extras. Now, the next order of business on this machine is to investigate the Y-axis. There seems to be a bit of backlash on that axis that does not exist on the X. I mean, I would expect there to be some backlash, but when comparing the X and Y, they're vastly different, so I need to dig into there and see what the problem is. I suspect that we might actually be missing some balls in the ball screw, so we'll have to dig into that and see what's happening there. So that's where I am with this project, and as things progress and I have more to show you, I'll stick another video up. And as always, if you like this kind of content, consider giving me a like or a subscribe, and I'll catch you next time.